Ramesh here, and today we'll know about one of the most fascinating space objects known as a star. We see around 5,000 stars in the sky, which is just a tiny drop in a cosmic ocean. It is estimated that our universe has more than 1 quadrillion or septillion number of stars, that is 1 followed by 24 zeros. Our sun is also a star, and it appears big from others because it is the nearest star to Earth. In the following animation, we will see some of the neighboring stars and how much time Voyager 1 will take to reach their fame. We'll be right back. a hot ball of plasma held together by its own gravity. Stars are born inside hydrogen business clouds called nebula. When the hydrogen clouds collapse due to gravity, material at the center begins to heat up. As a result, a protostar is born. Protostar is a very young star that is still gathering dust and gas from its molecular cloud. For a star like our Sun, this protostellar phase lasts about 500,000 years. As the compression of hydrogen gas continues, the core becomes so hot that the process of nuclear fusion starts, where hydrogen atoms fuse to form helium. In this process, some matter is lost, which is converted into energy, and a star is born. This relation of matter and energy was discovered by Albert Einstein by his famous formula E is equal to mc square, where E is the energy, m is the mass, and c is the speed of light. Stars are stable for billions of years because the inward pull of gravity is balanced by the outward pressure of gas heated by fusion, and this balance is called hydrostatic equilibrium. In its life cycle, it creates basic matter from which everything in the universe is made, including planets, moons, even life. Stars can be lonely like our Sun and form pairs, multiple systems and star clusters. Stars burn in different colors depending upon the surface temperature, from red, orange, yellow, white, blue. Morgan-Keenan system is used to classify stars, the hottest O type to the coolest M type. The upcoming video shows the size of stars and also provides details and its distance from the Sun in light year. A light year is an astronomical unit equivalent to distance traveled by light in 1 year. star consumes all the hydrogen in its core, nuclear fusion reaction suddenly stops, due to which core collapses into itself as no more energy is produced to counter the inward gravitational force. Still, there is hydrogen available outside the core, so hydrogen fusion continues there. As the core of the star getting hotter and hotter, it pushes the outer layers of the star outwards, resulting in the expansion of outer layers. Due to expansion, the star is now transformed into a red giant star. With no hydrogen left to fuel it, the star begins fusing helium into carbon, which generates a humongous amount of energy waves, which slowly disintegrate the star, and finally only the intensely hot stellar core is left. And now the star is transformed from red giant to white dwarf star. At this stage, the nuclear fusion process stops and star suddenly dies. A white dwarf is about the size of the Earth, but has the mass of a star. Our sun will also undergo the same life cycle and eventually become a white dwarf. An average star like our sun lives for billions of years. The more massive the star, the less its lifespan. In the next animation, we will look into the hottest, coolest, most and least massive stars. Let's get right into it.
Thank you.
When a star is massive, the core temperature goes high enough to fuse helium and produce heavier elements up to iron. In nuclear fusion process, elements heavier than iron consume energy instead of producing, due to which the star no longer counter the inward pull of the gravity, resulting in the collapse of the iron core. At this stage, the core temperature exceeds 100 billion degrees, which happens in seconds. Star outer layers along with its core collapse and bounce back with an enormous explosion known as supernova. Supernova can outshine entire galaxies and generate an unbelievable amount of energy, which is even more than what our sun will give in its entire lifetime. Stellar core with mass ranging from 1.4 to 3 solar mass collapse as gravity is so strong that electrons and protons combine to form neutrons, giving birth to a neutron star. On the other hand, if the core is larger than 3 solar mass, it collapses entirely and becomes a black hole. For more details on the black hole, you can watch Black Hole the Endgame video on the channel. In this last segment of the video, we will look into smallest, largest, brightest and variable stars in the universe. Let's see. that's it for today. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.